Hey, what's up? Hello, and welcome to the latest episode of She Thought She Could, So She Did podcast. So let me just catch you up, just in case that is not your genre of music. That is my good homie Donnie McClurkin singing We Fall Down, and it is setting the precedence for today's episode. We fall down, but we get up. You know, if you can look up, you can get up. I heard Les Brown say that. And the first time I heard him say that, I almost had a praise break all the way through my kitchen. And if you don't know what a praise break is, that's kind of when you just start shouting, giving God glory from like the depths of your spirit. Because if you can look up, you can get up. And every day is a chance to get up, to restart, to do it again. And it doesn't matter how many times you get up, as long as you keep getting up and you don't stay down. I say all of that to say, don't be afraid to restart. Don't be afraid to recharge. Don't be afraid to revamp. And there is no time frame on when you have to do that. You get me? Like, you feel me? Like, sometimes we'll think, okay, the first of the month, the first of the year, the first of the quarter, something like that. I don't care if it's Tuesday the 27th of whatever month and you feel like it's time to restart, recharge, revamp, do whatever it is you need to do for you. Just do it. It's a-okay, and there's absolutely like no rules on how this whole life things go. You know, it doesn't come with a how-to manual. And the beautiful thing about that is it is your job to create your manual. It is your job to create your greatness. It is your job to create your own cycle of whatever it is that you have going on. And you cannot allow life, society, family, whoever, whatever to dictate what it is that you have going on. It's my hope that you are engaged with the I Am She platform online. If you are not, go to www.IamShe.com. www.IamShe.com/blog. And I want you to head down to a blog entitled My Push to Restart. It was contributed by Aquella Treese of iJourney Blog, one of my great friends, fellow Coastal alum. And she gives some action steps to restarting, to being okay with that, and ways that she kind of restarted and revamped her blog and her whole vision for that thing. And one big takeaway for me was converting from talking to action. Sometimes in our lives, we'll talk about the things that we want. We'll talk about the things that we are working on. We'll talk about the ideas that we have. But when do we convert those words into action? And don't let me push you prematurely into action. No. We all need to go on our course. However, we can't talk and not be. At least having some action steps, whether that's picking up the pen and paper, getting real old fashioned and writing down the steps to get to where we want to go, or if that's jumping on the computer, doing some research because we have absolutely no idea where to start, whatever that kind of looks like. But taking those words and converting them into actual knowledge. And then a second key takeaway, believe in yourself. You are your biggest cheerleader. You are the captain of your own cheer squad. Therefore, if no one else shows up to practice, if no one else is at the game, if no one else is rooting for you, you bet to be rooting for you. You have to have your own best interest at heart at all times. And that is something that makes it easy when you reset and when you restart and when you recharge and when you re-up, okay? You are the one. You are the one to push yourself. You are the one to believe in your wildest dreams. You are the one that closes your eyes and sees the thing. You see the full picture. You see it all out. And it is not my job to see your vision, just as it isn't your job to see my vision. It isn't Bob's job to see Sally's. It isn't Sean's job to see Sue's. It is our individual responsibility to see our own vision for our life and our futures and our well-beings. And so it's our job to restart. It's our job to take a break. It is our job to not let the worries of the world bog us down in such a way that we just cannot see a way out. So I want you to vow to me that you won't allow society to set your restart. You're going to set your restart. And whenever that is, whenever the time is right for you and you decided that, you know what, I'm going to try one more time. I am not going to let anything defeat me. And I am going to be the captain of my own pep squad. Go me, go me. Like in the mornings, after my meditation and after I've read my scripture for the day, I am so pumping Tabitha up. I get in the shower and listen to a podcast. I'm looking in the mirror as I'm getting dressed and I am just talking to myself positive affirmations about today being a new day, and whatever today holds, that is what it holds. And as a multifaceted person, each day is different. No day looks the same. And so every day is like a restart over here in Tiny Tab Land. Like every day is something new. It's a new challenge. It's a new pull. It's a new tug of war. It's a new canvas, if you will. I'm not an artist, but just walk with me through a blank canvas and you are literally stroking on the canvas as you make decisions, as you have thoughts, as you go through your day-to-day. It is stroking on that canvas, just painting that big picture of your life. So don't be afraid to get some white paint, throw it on that canvas and start over. Don't be afraid when you're writing things down to scratch it out and start over. Ball it up. Get a new piece of paper. Take your eraser to it and just go ham as if you're in a first grade classroom. Don't be afraid to restart. And don't forget that you are the cheerleader of your own pep squad. You. All right. That's it for today's episode. I just want you to know that it is okay to restart whenever. It is okay to hit the reset button. And you have to take ownership of this thing that has called your life. All right? Deal? Capiche? Capiche? All right. Now I need you to do me a favor. I need you to screenshot this episode. I need you to share it with some friends. Subscribe to the podcast. Leave a comment. Leave some feedback. There have been some great episodes these last few weeks, and that is why the content isn't even that heavy today. Because last week with Shanita and the mental health, that transparency that she brought for us, listen, that was great. And I hear that there's a part two coming our way. Furthermore, the week before that, talking about serving time and who's talking about jail. For my newbies, go back and binge listen to some of the episodes. Get caught up on the flow of things here at the She Thought She Could podcast. I talk about things that are near and dear to me. So that's motivation, that's mental health, that's well-being. I might throw in some business tips, teaching you how to brand and how to mold and how to strategize, because strategy is my thing. Strategy girl, okay? So go back, binge listen, subscribe, share with a friend, leave some comments and feedback. Let me know some guests that you think I should bring onto the podcast. Let me know some topics you would like for me to talk about. Hop in the show notes so you can get the link to my latest book, Living Your Truth, a motivational memoir that can help you to navigate some things that you've been pushing under the rug. Or if you just want to hang out with me on social media or find out a little bit about me, there are some links that can help you do so. Have a good one.